Hello, boys and girls. Oh, jeez. Hello, boys and girls. Welcome to the Stevie Weeby podcast. Hey, looks like we have a special guest here today.
Hey,
what's your name?
What's up, Stevie Weeby?
We got OG Money Mark in here.
Hello,
ladies and gentlemen.
It's great to be here in the middle of Hollywood.
There you go.
Some lost streets.
You know what? I'm not going to even hang this up.
Close to Fountain.
Hey, man.
I'm sorry.
How about you play?
I don't want to give away your
how
location.
How about you play a little something on the piano that,
yeah.
You know, Mark gave me this piano. Why don't you just finesse it real
I love
quick.
This the patent French thing
this
right here.
This is the heirloom. Watch and learn, ladies and gentlemen. Head, man. Keep going, keep going. Money Mark's here, everybody.
Wow,
Money Mark's here.
Thank you, man.
Thanks for coming, buddy. Thanks for coming.
Yeah, man.
All right.
I'm glad to be here.
You like ginger beer, don't you?
I do. Why don't you get me a ginger beer?
Yeah, I'll get you one. I got an ice cold one.
I want some Pringles, too.
All right. You want some Pringles? We got gummy bears.
Pringles.
Bryce, you want a ginger beer?
Oh, sure, yeah.
Wow, the whole crew is getting ginger beer.
Oh, yeah, ginger beer for everybody.
Why do you need
everybody?
Six people to film this?
Ginger beer for everybody.
You got, like, wardrobe, stylist.
It's a little spicy. Watch out. It's a little spicy. Thanks for coming, man. We got a lot to talk about. Firstly, where did we just come back from, man?
We came back from... Oh, I like this beer.
It's pretty good, right?
I do.
It's better than the other ones, right?
Remind me of New Orleans.
Oh, yeah.
Wow. We just came back from New York City.
And why were we there?
We were there to entertain the crowd.
We were there. We did New York Fashion Week, didn't we?
We did part of the... we did like... it wasn't really Fashion Week, though. Really. It
was, I think for
before,
men's...
Before Fashion
right,
Week.
Right. It was like Devil Wears Prada up in there. it was a whole different world. we rolled up to the scene, and it was just... You know, I don't know much about fashion. It was cold. And Bryce, I didn't even have the right jacket. Everyone in the band were wearing a down, like North Face jackets. You had a good hoodie one, didn't you?
Yeah. had like some like...
A Target jacket.
Like, yeah.
A jacket from Target.
Marona. You had Walmart.
Shout out to Marona.
And Target on top.
Yep. And then there were skateboarding ramps where we walked in, huh?
Oh, yeah.
So this is it. This is what happened, folks. Steve Aoki, shout out to Steve for bringing us out, is releasing a new clothing line, is it? What is it called again?
I don't even know.
Dimmock Collection. Dimmock Collection. He's a fan of Dave Cho, and wanted some of Dave's artwork, yeah? And so someone in Steve's camp was a fan of Monchi? What's her name?
I think Steve's a fan of Monchi, too.
Oh, really? Okay.
Yeah, well, he is now.
But this gal, I forgot her name.
Amy.
Amy. The one
she's
that,
a designer, yeah.
Yeah, the designer of Dimmock. She was really rooting for us. And so we had did we get fitted the night before? We got fitted the night before. Yeah.
Basically, there was two skateboard ramps that connected, and then there was a stage there.
Yeah.
And we played. And the skaters wore the clothes and skated.
Yeah, so we had to wear the Dimmock clothing, and there was a whole, like, rehearsal, yeah.
Yeah.
It was a kind of a weird show, wasn't it?
It wasn't really a show. It was
it wasn't
more like
a show.
It was
a
like
bunch
a little...
of bloggers and
it was
fashion
bright.
People.
Yeah, we didn't really do our... We gave our energy and we did our thing, but it wasn't our show.
Yeah, it wasn't our show. It was basically, we would try our hardest, and it was like silence.
It was a fashion show.
It was a fashion show.
But now we put our own show.
That was a special show, wasn't it?
It was.
We had a special opener too, didn't we? He goes by Too Much Swag.
Too Much Swag.
He's basically like an internet sensation. Like he swag dances with the, what does he do with his hands? He does some.
It's like,
he does a weird like swag.
But
thing.
All the whole time.
But I'm telling you, he blew up on World Star Hip Hop, man. Got 700,000 views, and all he does is like walk around New York and do. He swags.
Yeah, he but swag all day dances. Long, it's like a. It's like Tourette's in your arms.
Yeah. Yeah, so he's like, you got to look him up, Bryce, after this whole thing. So he's a New York native.
Sometimes he goes like this.
Yeah.
And then
he like curls his wrists. Yeah, he swags out. But let's talk about the sound check that the night after the fashion show because,
the sound check.
Since we're on topic.
Hey, man.
We rolled up to the spot.
That was kind of and bogus, I looked at though. The.
What do you mean? Yeah,
bogus
we'll get to that.
We had to like do a sound check the day before. I never did that before. But whatever.
I mean, right. I thought that was kind of weird. But on the marquee, I noticed. Okay, we saw our name, right, Monchi. But then, right up like below us or whatever on the same roster was Main Source Reunion Show.
25 years.
And. The guy, the bouncer outside, I was talking to him, and I said, hey, is it Main Source? And I said this album. I go, Breaking Adam's Main Source? And that's when I got his attention, because he knew that I knew what I was talking about.
Right.
Because he probably thought I was a little younger cat.
But you know all the hip-hop.
But I know all the 90s hip-hop shit. So I go, man, I got that tape at home. And I don't know if you remember this. I met the guy with his glasses, Large Professor. He was there. During our sound check, and he heard the tail end of our sound check, and he gave us props.
Oh, wow.
He goes, oh, you guys sounded good. And I gave him respect, so shout out to Large Professor. You saw Premier, didn't you say DJ Premier? You saw a bunch of like
Premier
New York
yeah.
rap heads, right?
Let me see this.
Yeah, I got that.
But this was like 91, right?
91, 92. That was
almost like eight,
I mean,
in
that's
the 80s.
Like vinyl collectors, that's like a must have in their collection.
Wow.
Breaking Adams. So, you know, shout out to Main Source, 25-year anniversary. I mean, blessed to even rock the same stage as you guys. I wish I would have caught you guys' set, but, you know, we were kind of running
props
late. Yeah,
so Main Source.
Props to Main Source, Breaking Adams.
Breaking Adams.
You know, this is a special album because that song, Live at the Barbecue, Nas, that's how he blew up, one verse from Nas. Before he released his solo album. So this is a monumental album. It's when Nas, they kind of discovered Nas through this. If I'm thinking of it correctly.
I think you're right about that.
Yeah, I think I'm right about it, yeah. So, yeah. So that was weird.
Wow.
I saw them. Whoa, you killed it. You want another one?
Well, not right now.
Okay. You know, we got gummy bears. And,
oh, yeah, I'll have some gummy bears.
You want some mangoes?
Gummy bears, yeah.
Yeah, those are from, yeah. Hey, and then Bryce, if you get the mangoes.
Dude, I'm going to get all sugared up right now.
Well, you know, these are dried fruit. So shout out to Main Source. So what else? Let's the day of the show.
Oh, the show.
Was it sold out?
I think they said it was sold out. It seemed like it was sold out.
It was packed, dude. Go ahead, man. Go ahead.
During our set... Dave brought, Cho brought up TMS, Too Much Swag, and then he forced him to stage dive. He didn't really want, to stage dive, did he?
No, I mean...
Well, this is during the socks.
This
playing.
Was his first show. He's never done a show before this,
Bryce. Yeah, first show.
This was his first show ever. And,
And Dave forced him to stage dive, and he was scared. But
yeah, he was very scared.
Got on his back, and his kind of arms and legs were up.
Yeah,
and he didn't. He was kind of in shock.
Yeah,
he wasn't enjoying it.
And then we
he
kept
looked like
going.
A turtle that's been flipped upside down.
And then we told the audience,
then,
we go, Put them all the way to the back, to the bar.
The audience.
We made the audience.
Wait, from the stage to the bar?
Carry them all the way to the back.
Yeah, from the stage to the bar is pretty far.
Oh, yeah.
It's like 20 yards.
So imagine how tired their arms were. We're like, no, all the way. All the way to the bar. All the way.
All the way back. And he kind of disappeared. It kind of reminded me of like.
It was a spectacle, man.
Petite, high wiring into the clouds or something, but he disappeared.
That was a fun moment, man. That was a real fun moment.
I don't know how I guess he got down safely.
Yeah. But my favorite, I like that moment, but my favorite moment, man, something went wrong. Momo's mic went out. We didn't know what to do.
Just like that light went out. The mic went out, and then the light went out.
Or just pause?
Was that shirt? No, we don't pause.
No, you want to pause.
Don't pause. This is
Let's fix the light first.
Technical.
You want a new bulb? I got some bulbs.
Nah, man, we're still rolling.
We're still chilling?
We're still rolling.
So basically, the mic went out, just how the light went out, and so we had this kind of like in between time on stage, right? Would you say a couple seconds at least? And this guy,
we have to fill the time. The objective when you're on stage is to entertain the crowd.
Right.
Whatever happens, shit's gonna happen.
And then this maestro went into Benny and the Jets on keyboard. And that was probably, I was looking at people's reactions, man. They were digging that part of the set. They were like, man, this guy,
it was just like
he could
improv.
Do it for real.
Because it's like an improv.
Oh my God. People, like, you felt that. And then, don't you have a story behind that, Benny and the Jets? Didn't you play that in Madison Square Garden?
Yeah, the Beasties covered it. Aaron, with Biz.
With Biz Markie,
with
right?
With Biz singing it, yeah. Then we did a show at the Garden.
Mm-hmm.
And fucking Biz came up and sang the song with us.
You played that on the piano?
Yeah, I played it on.
Now, what was that like? Like Madison Square Garden, Beastie Boys concert, yeah?
It was like a Casio.
It was a Casio.
Yeah, it was like not a real piano.
How old were you when you did that? Because you told me this story before.
I was Flamingos
in the 90s. Too.
I was young.
I'm glad you brought up the Beastie Boys, man. Because, man, that's one of my favorite groups. I grew up with them. And so I still trip out that you're in Mongchi, and then you were once, during the timeline, you were with the Beastie Boys.
That's when you were into the Beastie Boys?
Dude, I like, skateboarders or whatever, grew up with Check Your Head and License to Ill. But my favorite's Paul's Boutique. But can you tell the audience a little of the history?
Right there.
Yeah, right there, dude.
Marauders.
Go ahead, Bryce. Get it.
The three guys right there.
Ad Rock, MC, Mike D.
Mike D.
I like how it's a triangle.
Yeah.
That's a great album. But anyway, how did you meet them again? What year?
I was in, I was kind of hanging out with Delicious Vinyl.
People. Okay, this was in the 90s.
Yeah.
Okay.
And they came and then they started working with Mario C and the Dust Brothers, and I knew those guys. And I was working, I was a set carpenter down the street at Hollywood Center Studios.
So it was just by chance.
Zoe Trope used to be Coppola's place.
Yeah.
Then it was Hollywood Center Studios, and I worked on that lot. It was like Pee Wee's Playhouse was there.
So it was around here somewhere?
Oh, we're talking Las Palmas.
Oh, Las Palmas. Yeah. Wow.
And so I'd drive home. Well, to drive home, I'd go to the freeway, but I'd pass by the Delicious, and then I'd see their cars out there, and I'd stop, hang out.
So you saw Ad Rock in there, or you saw them hanging out?
No, that's not where I met them, but okay. Yeah, there was some party a few weeks after that, and then that's how I met them.
Now, were they working on Paul's Boutique when you met
that's
them?
That's right.
They were. You told me that.
So it was like 88, man. Wow. Known those guys for a long time.
1988, children. That was a long time ago. It was probably before you guys, half you guys were born. That was a long time ago.
88.
Now.
2008. Wow.
That was like before Yo MTV Raps.
That's going to be like.
Yeah.
Don't tell me it's going to be like 30 years, 40 years.
Louise.
Wow. 30 years.
Now, didn't you also tell me that they were living in a house out here or something, right?
Yeah, they're staying at the G spot.
Okay, and what is the G spot?
Well, it's a house they were renting up in the hills and.
In the Hollywood Hills?
Yep.
Okay. And then the
guy who owned the house, I forgot his name. I don't know, Giovanni or whatever his name is, but he had G on the gate.
Uh-huh.
And then I remember after one of the parties, somebody ran into the gate and it fell over. And then I knew how to fix shit, and so I fixed the gate for them.
Like, you were good at fixing shit, weren't you?
That's right.
Like, man. Cupboards like I built cabinets
shit.
And
yeah,
stuff.
Yeah, I built
like,
shit. Well, you went on tour with me. If something breaks, I just fucking make it up.
I mean, this is a little off topic. You could actually create your own musical instruments, too. Like,
sure, I have done that, yeah.
Remember Big Bear, what you did?
Hey, man, that's the name of the game, man.
And stuff.
Look what I, yeah, man.
Oh,
I'm into old stuff. Look, see, I listen to this music.
So what's this?
This is old piano music, see? It's got the notes, these notes.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. I can play this music. I can hear it. I made this thing, you can hear it.
It's like Westworld.
Westworld's just the same.
Exactly. Westworld. This is what it's on it. And yeah. Believe me, maybe they got the idea from me.
Now, how many musical instruments can you play, just to tell the viewers? Because it seems like you can play everything to me.
If you give me an instrument, I'll just make some sound out of it, you know, for sure. But officially playing, you know, I'm just dabbling everything. Even piano, I just fake my way through it. But.
No, let's go back.
If you're a musician, and you can just play.
Yeah,
anything.
Right.
Yeah.
Let's go to Check Your Head. Let's fast forward there.
Came out in 92.
Because didn't you had a huge part in that, right? Just to let them know.
Yeah, I did. I played keyboards on all those songs and helped produce all those jams.
And then you were on the insert of the vinyl, weren't you? That was you on
that's right.
Mark's in the vinyl, so if you buy the vinyl.
I play on the So What You Want jam, the cha-cha-cha-cha-cha-cha, that stuff at the beginning.
Before Plug Me In, just like I was
in. That's my shit, yeah. The intro.
Did you know that? Now, that line, from here to Gardena, who are they talking about? Aren't you from Gardena?
Both Marcy and I were.
So that's a little history there. That line specifically was about him and Mario, because they were. Didn't you lug all your drums and all that gear for them to use?
We just all pitched in and made whatever happened.
Bryce, you like that album, man?
Not too familiar with them. A little too young. But
yeah.
Yeah, it's old.
It's
now.
A classic album, man.
1992, man.
If you're a skateboarder, a lot of skaters were into that.
Yeah, they were.
Yeah.
And, you know, Yalk put skaters in the videos, so that was kind of like one of the first times that skateboarding became a thing, you know, like,
It's kind of like crossbred, even fashion-wise, because I remember
MTV became an MTV thing.
Even that video, So What You Want, the beanies and the flannels, that's all Beastie Boys. Like, they had Extra Large, they had the store there on Vermont, right, or something. So it kind of like, they really influenced skateboarding in a way, yeah.
You still wear a beanie all the time.
I mean, half my style is because the Beastie Boys and Far Side and stuff like that. Right. I grew up with that.
How was it when we did a show with...
With who?
With homie. And
with which guy?
In Hawaii.
Who, Deltron?
Yeah.
Oh, I mean, that's a whole different... I mean, I grew up with hieroglyphics, and... You talking about Del?
Yeah, man.
Oh, come on, dude. That's... Del's like my...
You got to play...
You're my sensei, you know, as far as the music stuff, but as far as the rapping stuff, like, yeah. I look up to Del, like, the same way, musically, I look up to you, man. Like, Del... I don't know you that well, but, you know, keep doing your thing. I'm glad you're, like, still making music, man. Yeah, so hieroglyphics. Yeah. My homie Mestizo was more into Living Legend stuff, and I gravitated more to like towards exactly Dell. Firstly, Dell, because I saw Sleeping on Your Couch. Back to Yom TV Raps.
Yeah.
I saw that video on Yom TV Raps. Isn't it weird now how there's no really like music videos aren't like at the forefront of music? Because that's how I discovered music back in the 90s.
It's all different nowadays, man.
Yeah, it's like, just all over
the place. There's nothing to compare to right now. It's all just, everything's new. There's people getting nominated for Grammys and then they don't even sell a record. They didn't even sell one record.
How do you feel about that, man? Give it away.
It's just a whole nother world, you know.
Now let's tell the viewers how many, because you've collaborated with a lot of people, haven't you?
Well, that's mostly what I do.
Yeah.
Even our band, so I'm collaborating with everyone.
Just to let you guys know, if we didn't have him, we would have no sound. He came up with all the guitar riffs.
We did it as a team.
No, come on, man. I know what you did. You want another?
Yeah,
I did. Okay.
I do.
How it's far pretty is spicy, kitchen? Huh?
How far is the kitchen from here?
I don't have a kitchen. You know, this is a studio apartment.
Yeah, it's not bad.
Yeah.
I was just at that little the New Orleans restaurant in Chinatown.
What'd you get?
I got a blackened catfish po' boy.
Yeah.
But they have, like, I was going to bring you some, but next time I will. But they have a bunch of different kinds of ginger beer. We should go there and try all the
ginger. I like the ones that are spicy, man. Like, there's a...
Put some spice in it.
Yeah, that one. I really like that one.
They got
what's the one? We drank a lot of it. It's, I forgot the name of it.
The Jamaican one.
Yeah, the Jamaican one. Yeah,
right?
So, man, what do you think about, do you think Monchi, like, what do you think the future of Monchi is? Do you think, like, these one-off shows, or do you think that the fan base is growing and stuff as far as, because our live show is fun, right?
Someone had made that little doll for you, right, then that Monchi
yeah,
toy?
You got one, too. Should I break it out?
Yeah.
Hey, Bryce, grab that for me real quick, yeah? Yeah, so shout out to the fan who made this. It's like a G.I. Joe figure.
Yeah.
And, he goes by Caterpillar.
Yeah, it's on the back, too.
Yeah, so www.thecaterpillar.com. And don't you have one, too?
Maybe, I don't know.
So you made like a G.I. Joe figure of me.
And then
we also have...
Those.
This was in Oregon or Seattle?
Oh, that was when we were on that tour.
A fan, was it Portland? I want to say Portland, dude.
Portland.
We're just walking around, right? We're walking around, this guy, this Asian cat.
We were in the Pendleton shop.
Yes, we were in the Pendleton shop.
And we came out
and this dude just approaches us like, hey, are you, like Dave? And then this guy
These wooden dolls.
Every member had...
Look, they move, though.
Yeah, they move. Every member got one of these... Like, he made one of these.
Yeah, super fan.
So, dude, we were super psyched on that, dude. And we were like, dude, what's your name? You get tickets plus whatever. I like that. Guys, just people who just kind of approach you and they're like, here's a gift.
Yeah.
It's really nice, man.
Yeah, it's nice. People, we got a good fans.
Yeah, we got some amazing fans. So how we doing, man? Like, is there anything?
I bet they're upset that it was our last show.
I mean,
you know.
But is it our last show?
I don't know. But all the fans
are
like,
we gotta do Vegas, baby. We could definitely, I think we could cater to a Vegas style show, man. If we just kind of add more.
Do they have like a punky show in Vegas?
Maybe we could be the first one.
That would be, hey. It's probably
not
a bad idea.
Anyone in Vegas listens to this in the future.
That's not a bad idea.
What?
That's not a bad idea.
Because I thought about it. I'm like, okay, what makes sense to me? Because we have such a kind of a circus type act with different kinds of genres. Las Vegas, right? Don't they have wild shows? We have a wild show, man, you know? We could do a whole thing, man.
He's wearing a nut cup.
Yeah, should I break it out or what?
You
guys want to see it?
Yeah. Well...
I'm not
going to
wear it, but I'll show it.
What, you got it up on the mantle?
Yeah, man. This is the...
That's the official nut cup. Wait, didn't you have a space?
I don't know when this happened.
Wait, did you have a few of those?
It happened though.
Wait, you had a few of those, right?
Yeah, I washed the outside of it. So what happens if you want to wash it, you just take it out like and
wait, do you wash it?
Yeah, I washed it, man.
No, you don't.
You know, I did wash it. I washed it in Seattle. Or
but
Vancouver.
That, in Seattle, that was
No. This is clean, man. No, this is clean.
Wait, did you wash it?
Yeah,
I used Tide.
I used Tide. I remember.
Before New York?
Yeah, man, this is clean.
What about since we came back, though?
What do you mean?
Oh, come on, dude.
It's real clean.
Oh, my God.
So, you know what happened? I think they're getting desensitized to it because I broke it out in New York.
And no one cared.
And no one really cared. So yeah. I'm like, what's next?
They wanted you
to go naked.
They wanted you to get naked.
Well, you're already butt naked. Yeah.
They wanted you to go naked.
Just naked. Yeah. Or a fox. What's that thing Dave bought me? You can tell them.
Dave's got to wear
No, no, no. He went to a store.
Oh, Dave.
You could tell them.
Well...
I don't mind.
Oh, man.
That was in Tacoma. It was in Tacoma, Washington.
An anal plug. So but it like has...
He goes before... But, after sound check, he runs to a porn, like some adult store, and he wants me to get this fox, this butt plug, a foxtail. And he was begging me, please, oh, dude, please, please. But then when I took it out of the package, I'm telling you, it was like so big.
It was like a tennis ball.
It was like a Nerf football, man. And I told him, man, I'm not sticking that up my ass. You're out of your mind. I said, you're out of your goddamn mind. I'm not sticking that in my ass.
Wait. Then we look on the package and that says large.
No, it said small.
It did?
Yes.
What?
The thing was this big with the foxtail attached to it. God dang you, Dave. No.
Then Dave went to another store.
Oh, I didn't know that. He went to another one?
And then he compared it, and I think that one was in a wrong package.
Oh.
That was a large.
I'm telling you, how are you going to fit that up your anal canal, man?
Like this Pringles.
It was huge. It was this big. It was a little bit smaller than
Yeah, but you weren't going to wear that anyway.
Oh, hell no.
Even if it fit.
He wanted me to do it so bad.
All right, so what you're saying is our next, if we do some more shows.
I want to do Vegas.
How are you going to like step that up higher?
If like Vegas? If something like that happens. I don't know. It's either naked or...
Wait, how do you get booked in Vegas? Anybody out there?
I don't know. I don't know how you would get booked in Vegas, but...
If you build it, they will come.
What's that movie? Field of Dreams,
baby. Nightly punk act, right?
Yeah, or something.
We do the same show
I mean,
every
we could
night.
Offer something for
I couldn't
you,
do
man.
That, man.
Vegas.
But the same
and that
show
way, there's money
night.
There, man.
Yeah, but... The same show every night? I can't do that.
But
the same show every night? The same jokes?
But that's how what all those other acts, they do it, right? They do the same shit over and over
again. Yeah, but that's like a...
I don't know. I mean, that's just an option. Right. Either that or we go to Europe or something like that. All right, man. I think... how are we doing on time? That was pretty good, yeah?
That's great, yeah.
Well... Or if you see it,
Mark, is there anything else you want to? Come on, man. Do we cover a lot of stuff?
All right. Let's go over five different ones we covered, right? Vegas. If anyone can book us in Vegas,
Europe.
Oh yeah, let's go to Europe.
Or Asia. I've never been to Tokyo. So.
All right. So someone try to book us then.
Yeah, if you see this, we want to go to Tokyo. Seoul, Korea, Thailand, Philippines, Berlin, France.
We want everyone to experience the nut.
Oh, Copenhagen. I want to go. Oh, Australia.
Oh, some of the
couple
places,
heads people hit me up, man.
Some of those places you can't wear a nut cup. Get the rest.
Really?
Maybe.
Then I'll wear a uniform, man. I'm not tripping.
Australia.
We want to go to wherever you guys are at. We have an hour set.
All right, man. Thanks for having me here.
That wasn't so bad, was it?
No. What's up with Little Ray's World?
Ooh. Little Ray's World?
Yeah.
Hold up.
I love all this little cowboy
Welcome
stuff here.
Welcome to Little Ray's World Show. Well, what do we have here? How you doing there, little lady? You look lost. Can I help you? Well, my name is Raymond, but they call me Little Ray. I've had a hectic couple of weeks. I was hanging out with a reptilian 1 week, and then I was hanging out with this little alien gray. God dang! What's that smell? It smells rather peculiar around here. It smells like poo. What did you say your name was again? Betty Boop? Oh, Betty Poop. Well, that explains the smell. Darn it, man. I don't know how long I can stand here. Well, no, I have a girlfriend back there in Bryan, Texas. And no, I can't kiss you on the lips. Tell you what, I'll let you kiss me on the cheek if you find some Febreze. Is there Febreze in this weird dimension? Okay, let's go get some Febreze.
Dagnabbit, you smell like poop, Betty Boop. You need some Febreze. Let me tell you about it, man. Met a girl named Betty Boop, smell like poop upon the stoop. Pulled her fingered on a loop, didn't know what to do, so I had a bubble pot. New floss that I would rot, had to pinch my nose with tippy toes and clothes and stinky clothes. Lord, can you set me free? Where's my horse I truly need? Had to do a store to buy a new bottle of Febreze. Stuck the weird dimension now, rather be with the cow. You were both picked me up, took me there, I got the key. Give me some Febreze, so my ear knows Febreze. Met a girl named Betty Boop, smelled so bad I had a scoop. Raymond had it, take the lead, almost made my nostrils bleed. If it was all up to me, I'd soak my body.
Join us next week for another episode of Little Ray's World. Artwork this week done by Alani. See you next week, boys and girls.